everyone, friends, followers, brothers of this Batala TV, you are learning and training platform about business courses, and this platform give you some suggested answer for various exams asked in job exams. So I'm your partner, I'm called Benone. I'm also going to give you suggested answer for loan officer exams. Dear friend, dear followers of this Batala TV, I'm also going to beg you to subscribe on this YouTube channel, to share the video of this YouTube channel, like this video, in order to get new update about two other videos. And what you're going to do about two videos is motivated to us. So dear friend, dear followers, this is the writing test or loan officer exam. So this is the instructions of the our exam questionnaire. Dear friend, dear followers, our exam questionnaire you see that our exam questionnaire containing five questions. So in this session, we're going to give suggested answer for our questions asked in this questionnaire, for our five questions. Dear friend, dear followers of this Batala TV, let me starting by reading the instruction of the exam. So the first instruction is write your code as identification. Reading material related to the test are not allowed. Attempt all the questions within 1 hour. So all questions carry equal marks, 10 marks. So we are going to state and giving the suggested answer starting to question one. So the question one has sub questions, question A and question B. So we are going to start by giving suggested answer to this sub question 1A, which stated that highlight and light a short note on the five key responsibilities of loan officers. So the question is asking to highlight the five key responsibilities of loan officers. So we are going to give suggested answer for these key responsibilities of loan officers. So dear followers of this Batala TV, the responsibilities of loan officers are flows. The first responsibilities, loan officer assess credit proposal drawn by commercial officers. Assess credit proposal drawn by commercial officers. The second responsibility of loan officer is to determine whether a proposed loan constitutes the risk return that Umurenge SACCO requires. To determine whether the proposed loan constitutes the risk return that Umurenge SACCO requires. The third responsibility is of loan officer assist and advise the credit committee in evaluating the credit proposal. The loan officer assists and advises the credit committee in evaluating the credit proposal. The fourth responsibility of a loan officer is the loan officer have responsibility to draw credit letters in accordance with the credit committee approval. A loan officer has a responsibility to draw credit letters in accordance with the credit committee approval. So the fifth responsibilities of loan officer, the loan officer archive loan files and determine the completeness of loan files before disbursing it. The sixth responsibility of loan officers, the loan officers has responsibility to comply with all applicable Banque Nationale du Rwanda requirement, BNR. So the loan officer has also responsibility to draw a credit report for internal and external uses. Loan officer has a responsibility to draw the credit report for internal or external uses. The loan officer has also responsibility to assist and support and train the commercial officer in credit related issues. So this is the question number A, which asking to state to highlight the some key responsibilities of a loan officer is ended here. The some key and the some key responsibilities of a loan officer is this. So the question A, question one, sub question B is asking, stated that as a loan officer of a SACCO, discuss the channel from loan application up to loan approval. Batubaza hano kuganira inzira binyuramo kuva inguzanyo irimo gusabwa kugeza inguzanyo yemejwe. The first channel is interview with the customer, possibly succeeded by an application. Hano loan officer atangira aganira n'umukiriya, aganira n'umukiriya igihe umukiriya ahanini aje gusaba inguzanyo. The second is visit customer. Iyo loan officer amaze kuganira n'umukiriya, igikurikiraho no gusura umukiriya. Hakabaho kwandika business plan kumukiriya. Write the business plan. Assessment of plan. Loan officer asuzuma ya business plan. Agakurikiraho decision on loan. Loan officer agafata umwanzuro kuri ya nimba aratanga inguzanyo. Bitewe n'umwanzuro yafashe, yandika a credit letter, ayandikira credit committee kugira ngo nabo babyigeho. Iyo birangiye, obtain grant. Loan officer agomba kubona ingwate, agomba kubona title y'icyo usaba inguzanyo agwatirije. Yamaje kubona title y'icyo usaba inguzanyo agwatirije, habaho gusinya amasezerano y'iki y'inguzanyo, sign a loan agreement. The second step, the following step is to approve, is to approve the loan payment schedules. Hano igikurikiraho none ni ukwemeza uburyo ki umukiriya azagenda approve payout schedule payment, uko azagenda bishyura inguzanyo. The another step is monitoring of create and review of the credit application. The last one is recovery. So you are going to give also suggested the answer for the question 2. The question 2 also is comprised with sub question A and sub question B. The sub question A stated that give in detail the role of a SACCO to its create in the Rwanda society in general. Uratubaza ngo dutange n'uyu mumaro wa SACCO ku bakiriya bayo no kuri sosiyete nyarwanda muri rusange. Igisubizo, answer: in general, umurenge SACCO accelerate access to financial services for Rwandanese power and rural populations. Muri rusange imirenge SACCO yihutisha kuba abaturage mu Rwanda babakene cyangwa se n'abaturage baba mu byaro babona serivisi z'imari muri rusange. Urugero hano, umurenge SACCOs provide access to savings and borrowing to their create in a way that allow them to smooth cyclical household consumption partners and manage unexpected emergencies. Hano umurenge SACCO utanga utuma abaturage bakenye cyangwa se abaturage bo mu byaro babasha kwizigamira, babasha kuba baguza amafaranga muri SACCO kugira ngo ndeye amafaranga bizigamiye cyangwa se bagujije abashe kuba yabafasha mu byo bakenera gukoresha cyangwa se no kuba bakemura ibindi bintu bishobora kubanzaho batabiteganyije. Another example is umurenge SACCOs help their create to assess to financial services draft regulated institutions. Hano akandi kamaro kumurenge SACCO mu gutanga za serivisi z'imari ku baturage bo mu cyaro nuko umurenge SACCO ubegereza izo serivisi z'imari ariko biciye muri icyo kigo kiba kigengwa n'amategeko. Mu gihe imirenge SACCO itaraza wasangaga b'abaturage bo mu cyaro bashobora nko kujya kuguza amafaranga bakajya muri za banki rambere za banki zitagengwaga n'iki n'amategeko. The umurenge SACCOs are implementation tool for government of Rwanda program. Hano umurenge SACCO wifashishwa na Leta y'u Rwanda na Guverinoma y'u Rwanda mu gushyira mu bikorwa gahunda za Guverinoma y'u Rwanda. Ako nanone ni akamaro k'umurenge SACCO kuba yifashishwa, none gahunda z'u Rwanda zikaba zashyirwa hehe mu bikorwa. Ingero hano dufite umurenge SACCOs are Rwandan program for linking savings group to financial institutions. Hano umurenge SACCO itaraza n'ubundi habagaho amatsinda. Umurenge SACCO waje muri gahunda y'igihugu kugira ngo noneho ya matsinda yabaga ariho yo kubitsa no kugurizanya bayahuze n'icyo kigo kimara aricyo cyitwa SACCO. Ako ni akandi kamaro kuba imirenge SACCO ihuye n'iki n'amatsinda yo kubitsa no kuguriza. Another example is umurenge SACCOs are financial sector development plan CCDP for implementation government of Rwanda's ADPRS. So hano nanone umurenge SACCO washyizweho mu buryo bwo guteza imbere financial sectors. Leta ifite icyo twita financial sector development plan. Plan zashyiriweho kugira ngo ziteze imbere ibigo by'imari. Muri iyo plan rero na SACCO nayo irimo, ni imwe muri plan kugira ngo ibigo by'imari bitere imbere. Ariko iyi ngiyi financial sector development plan ikaba iriho kugira ngo igihugu cyangwa se guverinoma y'igihugu izabashe kujya kuba twagera kuri izi ntumbero za economic development and poverty reduction strategy ADPRS. So imurenge SACCO waje muri aka gace ka economic development, imurenge SACCO nayo ifite akamaro ko kuzamura ubukungu. Another examples for as the SACCOs are implementation tools of a government of Rwanda program, the vision of the program are connected to the SACCOs for its implementation. VUP are connected to the SACCOs for its implementation. The Umurenge SACCOs are connected to the health mutual designed to finance medical insurance premium for vulnerable populations. Another role of SACCOs is Umurenge SACCOs act as capital or financial resources accumulation tool, for instance. Ari ukuvuga ngo Umurenge SACCO uhagaze cyangwa se uriho nkaho wakoreshwa mu buryo bwo kurundarura cyangwa se bwo kuba wakizigamira igishoro cyangwa se amafaranga yo kuzakoresha mu bihe runaka. Urugero, for instance, Umurenge SACCO acts as a source of a capital accumulation in Rwanda in order to become a self-reliant nation with the ability to plan for a better future and grow stronger economy. Umurenge SACCO angaha amafaranga arimo wifashishwa kuba wagenda ukusanya amafaranga mu gihugu cyacu, kuba SACCOs igenda ikusanya amafaranga. Ibi byadufasha kuba twaba igihugu kigize dufite ubushobozi kuba twategura ejo hacu heza, kandi n'ubukungu bwacu bukagira ibiki bugatera imbere. Muri rusange Umurenge SACCO ufite akamaro ko gukusanya cyangwa se ko kugenda wongera capitals cyangwa se financial resources. Urundi rugero, another example, Umurenge SACCOs accumulate financial resources for their create in the form of providing a fixed account to their create. Aha ngaha kandi kamaro k'Umurenge SACCO nanone dufatiye kuri capital or financial accumulations nuko ubasha kugenda urundanya financial resources, amafaranga y'abakiriya bayo, ariko biciye kuba iha serivisi abakiriya babo, kuba bafunguzamo konti boroke. Nimba umukiriye afunguje konti boroke Umurenge SACCO, ibyo nyuma y'igihe runaka, nyuma y'amezi atandatu, nyuma y'umwaka, ashobora kuzifashisha ya mafaranga ayashora imari ku bindi bintu bitandukanye. Umurenge SACCO enable members to accumulate financial resources needed to plant additional crops or add new income generating activities. Angana n'ubundi Umurenge SACCO ugumya ufasha abanyamuryango bayo, abakiriya bayo, kuba bakomeza kurundanya amafaranga azakenerwa wenda wenda mu gihe cy'ihinga, kubera ko n'ubundi izi serivisi iziha abaturage bo mu cyaro, cyangwa se kuba bazanikorera ibindi bikorwa bibyara inyungu. Another role of Umurenge SACCO, SACCOs are the government of Rwanda national saving mobilization strategies. igihugu cyacu guverinoma yacu ikangurira buri muturage uwo ari wese imukangurira kwizigama kwizigama rero kugira ngo bigere no kuri baba turage bakenye no kuri baba turage bo mu cyaro umurenge SACCO yaje nkaho ari mobilization tools ize kumobiliza iza gukangurira baba turage bo hasi baba turage bo mu cyaro batari basobanukiwe n'ibyo kwizigama kugira ngo nabo bizigane akona ko nakamaro kasaba. So the sub question B is stated that after giving the meaning of a stakeholder, list at three stakeholders of SACCOs and two sources of funds used by SACCOs. Hano batuye ngo dutange ubusobanuro bw'umugenerwabikorwa tunavuge nibura batatu mu bagenerwabikorwa ba SACCO tuvuge n'ahantu SACCO ishobora gukura amafaranga. So stakeholders are any party which can affect or be affected by the activities of an organization. Iyo tuvuze umufatanyabikorwa ni umuntu uwo ari we wese ushobora kuba yakafitinga cyangwa se yaba affected n'ibikorwa bya organization. So the stakeholders of SACCOs are FROs, the National Bank of Rwanda, BNR, National Bank of Rwanda, BNR. BNR nayo ni umufatanyabikorwa wa SACCOs. Hano tugiye kureba uburyo BNR ashobora kwafekta cyangwa se ashobora kuinfluensa SACCOs cyangwa se SACCOs nazo zishobora kuinfluensa BNR. So BNR is mandated to regulate and supervise microfinance institutions. First of all, Banki Nasiyonali y'u Rwanda yatorewe kugira ngo iyobore kandi inagenzure imikorere y'ibigo by'imari ziciriritse. Microfinance institutions include saving and credit cooperative, SACCOs, and limited companies that operate microfinance activities. Wango ibeneri yatorewe kuyobora no kugenzura ibigo by'imari ziciriritse harimo niyi SACCOs. So ni gute rero BNR ya affecting cyangwa se be affected by the SACCOs? So the supervision is conducted through three main activities. Tugiye kureba hano ibikorwa BNR ikora tukabona ko nubundi bya affecting iki bya affecting SACCOs. Icyambere A, licensing of microfinance institutions, nitanga license, nitanga uruhushya kugira ngo izi microfinance institutions harimo na SACCO zikore. Kuvuga ngo haramutse hariho SACCO, iyo SACCO nihabwa uburenganzira, nihabwa uruhushya na BNR licensing, ntabwo yakora. Ikindi ikorera ku bigo by'imari ziciriritse, BNR provide oversight of site surveillance. The BNR will promote the introduction of a computerized management information system in the microfinance institution to ensure adequate reporting. Hano ni ubugenzuzi ariko bukorwa na BNR idahari ibikorera ibi bigo by'imari ziciriritse harimo na SACCO. Urugero hano BNR cyo twita oversight surveillance, BNR will promote the introduction of a computerized ishobora kuzana uburyo bwo gutanga raporo ariko hakoreshejwe ikoranabuhanga. Ibyo bikaba byatuma raporo ikorwa neza. So see another influences of BNR is on site inspection of microfinance institution thus licensed. So hano BNR nanone ikorera ubugenzuzi ihibereye kuri za microfinance yahaye uburenganzira bwo gukora, ikaza igakora audit ubugenzuzi mubigo by'amasaku bifite uruhushya bwo gukora as a saving and credit cooperative on site supervision. The banner will further improve the number and the quality of on-site visit to the financial institutions operating under the micro finances. The other stakeholders are the Rwanda Cooperative Agents, RCA, ikigo cy'igihugu gishinzwe ama cooperative. Nawe n'umufatanyabikorwa w'amasaku. Uyu mufatanyabikorwa ni gute noneho we ya affecting ibikorwa bye bya affecting SACCO cyangwa se ibyo SACCO yakora bishobora kuba affected n'ibikorwa bya RCA. Icyambere A, RCA supervises the compliance of the SACCOs with the cooperative law. Ikigo cy'igihugu gishinzwe amakoperative kizaza kigenzure niba SACCOs ikora ariko yubahiriza itegeko rigenga amakoperative. The agent is in charge of the registration, regulation, inspection, and audit of a cooperative. Ikigo kizandika amakoperative nicyo kizagira uruhare mu kuyobora, mu kugenzura amakoperative, harimo amasako cyangwa se umurenge SACCOs. One of its key areas of work will continue to be capacity building of umurenge SACCOs. Ikigo cy'igihugu gishinzwe amakoperative kizagira uruhare nanone ku masakos mu buryo bwo kububakira, bwo kubakira imirenge ubushobozi imirenge SACCOs. RCA will provide the technical support to the umurenge SACCOs and the financial support to the umurenge SACCOs that have not reached financial sustainability. Hano ikigo cy'igihugu gishinzwe amakoperative gishobora gutanga inkunga ku mirenge SACCOs bya ku technical support mu bigendanye n'imikorere, mu bigendanye n'amafaranga, inkunga zirebana n'imikorere, bababwira uko bakora cyangwa se financial support bakabafasha mu buryo bugendanye n'amafaranga kuri ya mirenge SACCO that have not reached to the financial stability. Kuva ngo ino mirenge SACCO bafasha ni ya mirenge aho inyungu babonye zitabasha kugira iki bukavaringa expense bagize ibiki bakoresheje. An important role of the RCA is supporting the consolidation process of the imirenge SACCOs. Hano RCA nayo ishobora kuzagira uruhare mu guhuza muri process yo guhuza imirenge SACCOs. So undi mufatanya bikorwa wa gatatu wa SACCOs are the Association of Microfinance Institutions of Rwanda, AMI. Iyi ni association y'ibigo by'imari ziciriritse mu Rwanda. So most microfinance institutions lack the financial means to pay the external training and the consultants. Microfinance institutions are dependent on the free or almost free training offered by AMI. So urabona ko hano ahanini ibigo by'imari ziciriritse harimo za SACCO zibura amafaranga yo kuba bakishyura wenda nk'amahugurwa cyangwa se no kuba amafaranga yo kuba bahabwa iki ubujyanama. Iyi AMIR ikikora ni uko yo ibasha kuba bya bindi babura yabiba ikaba izo free training, external training, kandi ikaba yabaha n'ubwo bujyanama ku buntu. Urumva ko nayo igira influence mu bikorwa bya SACCO. Abandi bafatanyabikorwa batubwiye eshatu ariko reka tubivuge muri detail nta kibazo. Here we are learning donor initiatives such as Aquadev, Telafina, Watch and Sebufik. So several international organizations offer a range of training program for microfinance institutions including umurenge SACCOs in Rwanda. Ibi nabyo ni ibigo mpuzamahanga bishobora kugira uruhare mu mikorere ya SACCOs, batanga nk'ama training program kuri bigo by'imari ziciriritse. Abandi bafatanya ibikorwa ba SACCO dufitemo abakiriya ba SACCO, the creator of SACCOs, and another is the employees of SACCOs, the government, also at the stake or at the stakeholders of the SACCOs. So you are going to see the sources of fund to SACCOs, sources of finance to SACCOs. Ese SACCO ikura he amafaranga, sibyo? Tufite hano sources of the standard funding sources. So the first one we have equity source. Several microfinance investment vehicle also offer equity finance. Tuwana nimba haraho SACCOs cyangwa se ishoye imari ahantu runaka, aho ngo hazaba sources of finance, hazaba sources of finance through financial income, deposit and debt. External funding sources can provide microfinance institutions with longer term funding. Amafaranga abakiriya bayo baza bakabikamo, murabizi neza ko amafaranga babikamo abari liabilities kuri bank, ako kubujyanya amafaranga, izo ni sources of finance. Debt imyenda na sakwe ishobora gufata. Another sources is a commercial bank funding. Some banks have already explored the partnership with microfinance institution and will be stimulated to close on lending deals. Hano commercial bank banki z'ubucuruzi zishobora kugira imikoranire n'amasakozi n'ibigo by'imari ziciriritse, nuno zikaba zabakangurira cyangwa se zaba tera motivation yo kuba bajya muri deal yo kuba bashobora kubaguriza amafaranga. Izo commercial bank nazo zaba sources of fund to SACCOs. Another sources which is important are national wholesale sources. National wholesale sources means that the BDF, Business Development Fund, will actively offer its financing option to the microfinance industries. Hano iki kigega gishinzwe iterambere ry'amabusiness zishobora gutanga uburyo bwo kuba cyatanga inguzanyo kuri za microfinance industries n'imirenge SACCO irimo. Umunye SACCO ushobora gukenera amafaranga ukajya kuguza muri BDF. Another sources is international funding, including from social investors. The savings are key sources of funding for microcredit and can be mobilized by SACCOs. So interest from loan, interest received from loan baba atanze ku bakiriya bayo, izo ni sources of income. Loan fees, izindi fees zishobora kuza bashobora kwakira ziturutse ku nguzanyo batanze ariko atari interest. Alone is another sources of fund. So we are going to answer to question 3. So the question 3 also have sub question A and sub question B. So the sub question A stated that what the future value of Rwandan franc 2 million at interest rate of 24% if it compounded annually, semi-annually, quarterly and monthly for 2 years. Turatubwira ngo ni dushake amafaranga yazaboneka haramutse hashowe miliyoni 2 ku rwunguko rwa 24% ubwo rwunguko A ruzaza ruboneka rubazwa mu gihe cy'umwaka, mu mwaka rubonekemo rimwe cyangwa mu mwaka rubonekemo kabiri cyangwa mu mwaka rubonekemo magendo barobara inshuro enye cyangwa se mu mezi 12 mu gihe cy'imyaka 2. Uko mubibona dufite the data given you have present value is equal to the Rwandan franc 2 million, interest rate 24%, time number of years is equal to 2 years, future value ni irimo kubazwa future value equal to present value times the future value interest factor. So we are going to give present value twice future value interest factor nayo tujize biki twice. So igihe none interest rate zaba compounded annually inshuro mu mwaka, the present value yacu the future value yacu is equal to the present value times the future value interest factors. So we see that the present value is equal to 2 million and future value interest factors is equal to 1.3576. And when we apply this, we see that the future value of this amount compounded annually for 2 years is equal to 1,375,200. So when interest rate compounded is semi annual, when interest rate compounded is semi-annual. So also the future value, we take the present value and the times the future value interest factor. We see that the future value is equal to 2 million times the 1.5735,1936, which is equal to 1,347,039. So the where interest rate compounded quarterly. Compounded quarterly the future value is also we take the present value, but the future value interest factor we are going to use is compounded quarterly. We divide by the interest rate by fee, and the future value will equal to 3,173,749. So when interest rate compounded monthly, so future value is equal to take present value of 2 million times the future value interest factor compounded monthly, and our future value will equal to 3,216,870.74. So the sub question B is stating that what is the time required to double 1,10,000,000 deposited in SACCOs if the interest rate of 10% is compounded annually. Hano baratubaza dushake igihe nimba hashowe nimba cyangwa se hagujijwe cyangwa se habikijwe muri SACCO miliyoni 10 ku rwunguko rw'icumi ku ijana ruboneka mu mezi 12 kugira ngo urwunguko ruzikube inshuro ebyiri. So the data given, we have present value equal to 10 million, future value equal to 20 million. Zivihe yonko watabwiye ko aya mafaranga future value nuko azaba yida yidaburinze yikubye inshuro ebyiri. So the future value is equal to 20 million. Interest rate 10% compounded annually, time or number of year izi question mark nicho kirimo kubazwa. So this is the formula, this is the process flow for calculating the n. So nkuko bisanzwe tuzi ko future value ingana na present value, dukubyeho future value interest factors. Mu mibare rero angaha log ya future value, log of future value equal to log of present value times future value interest factors. So ibi nabyo ibyo hejuru bigana na log ya future bitanga log ya future value ingana na log ya present value duteranyijeho log ya future value interest factors. So log ya future value dukuyemo log ya present value bizangana na n za dukubye compounded n compounded dukubye log ya future value interest factors. Tubone ko ya myaka n compounded ingana na log ya future value dukuyemo log ya present value tukagabanya log ya future value interest factors. Nono n ya myaka barimo kutubaza tugafata ya n iri compounded tugabanyije compounded period. So when we go on the figures, we see that nm, we have the future value. We have seen that the future value is equal to 20 millions and minus log of present value. Log of present value is equal to present value is equal to 10 millions and divided by the log of the future value interest factors. So the log of 20 million is equal to 7.301029996 and the log of the present and the log of the 10 million is equal to 7 and divide the log of the future value interest factor. So we see that the n compounded is equal to 7. The n, which is the number of which is the time which are going to be asked, is equal to nm n compounded times compounding period. The compounding period in our question is annual, is 1. So the n is equal to 77. So the time required to double or 1/10 million is equal to 7 years. Well, we are going to do about two question 4. So the question 4 is also composed by two sub questions. We are going to start to sub question number A. The sub question for number A stating that the KIC Kayonza Hii cooperative is to undertake a project that will cost 104 million to be taken as loan from SACCO and to generate annual cash inflow of 1 million, and what is the project payback period? Hano turimo turabazwa gushaka payback period. Barakubwira ngo ino Kayonza Hill cooperative hari umushinga igiye gukora, ariko ubasaba miliyoni enye bagiye kuguza muri SACCO. Bakaba bateganya ko uri mushinga buri mwaka uzaza ubinjiriza miliyoni imwe. None barakubwira ngo ni ikihe gihe ni ikihe gihe uramushinga uzagaruza amafaranga yose ni ikihe gihe uramushinga uzagaruza ziriya miliyoni enye ako nkuko tubibona hano nimba umushinga buri mwaka ugarura miliyoni kandi umushinga waratwaye miliyoni enye as you see in this table in this table the mu mwaka wa zero bagitangira bazaba umushinga nta mafaranga muri zero nta mafaranga bazaba amafaranga bazaba afite ijo nta mafaranga bazaba bagitangira mwaka nta mafaranga bazaba afite ahubwo bazaba basabwa ko bakishyura ziriya miliyoni enye ariko mu mwaka wa mbere tugitangira umwaka wa kabiri umwaka wa mbere nurangira basaba amaje kwinjiza miliyoni imwe miliyoni imwe mubone kwenda mu kigega harimo miliyoni imwe babe babura kuba babona miliyoni eshatu ugereranyije na bashoye muri uwo mushinga ku mwaka wa kabiri bazongera babone miliyoni imwe niyo tuyitanya ko babonye mu wundi mwaka wabanje babe babonye miliyoni ebyiri n'ubundi babona miliyoni ebyiri kugira ngo umushinga wabo ugaruze ayo bashoye ku mwaka wa gatatu bazongera babone indi miliyoni imwe isange miliyoni ebyiri bari bamaje kubona zibe miliyoni eshatu tubone ko umushinga urimo kubura miliyoni imwe kugira ngo ugaruze ayo twashoyemo mu mwaka wa kane rero nuzana indi miliyoni imwe n'ubundi bizaba bigaragara ko umushinga umaze kuzana miliyoni enye ari nazo zashowemo tubone ko amafaranga abura kugira ngo umushinga ugaruze ayo bawushoyemo ari zero so the project payback period is four years. Another sub question B also related to the project payback period. So the project W and A will cost 9 million. Unexpectedly, project W and A will cost 9 million. Unexpected cash inflow 1 over the entire life of the project is six years is as flow. We have years, year 1, year 2, year 4, year 5, and year 6. Cash inflow in year 1, 2 million, year 2, 3 million, year 3, 3 million, year 4, 4 million, year 5, 2 million, year 6, 2 million. Required to calculate payback period for the W and E project. So, the table showing the calculation of a payback period. So, we have year 0, we have -9. Million accumulated cash flow is 0 and the remaining cash flow is equal to 9 million. Umwaka wa mbere hano umushinga uzabinjiriza miliyoni ebyiri ubwo babe babonye miliyoni ebyiri azo zibaye cumulative babe babura miliyoni zirindwi kugira ngo bagaruze ayo bashoye umwaka wa kabiri bazabona miliyoni eshatu nk'uko ikibazo kibitubwira miliyoni eshatu nizisanga za zindi ebyiri babagaruje miliyoni eshanu mu yo bashoye muri wa mushinga babura miliyoni enye ku mwaka wa gatatu bazabana miliyoni eshatu zize zisange za zindi eshanu bari bamaje kubona zibe miliyoni umunani ku yo bashoye babe babura miliyoni imwe mu kibazo batweretse ko umwaka wa kane azabona miliyoni umwaka wose uzarangira mu mezi 12 umwaka wose uzarangira wabonye miliyoni enye mu mezi 12 icyo tugiye gushaka niba miliyoni enye ziboneka mu mezi 12 ese miliyoni imwe izaboneka mu mezi angahe izaboneka mu mezi angahe nk'uko bigaragara hano harabura miliyoni the Rwandan franc is 1 million remaining we added in 12 month mezi 12 ari ndi mu mezi 18 kugira ngo tubone rero no igihe ino miliyoni bayibonye turafata mezi 12 dukwe na miliyoni tubonye na miliyoni enye tubone ko ino miliyoni yabonwe mu mezi angahe atatu. So the project payback period is 3 years with 3 months kuba ngo uramushinga wabo uzagaruza amafaranga bashoyemo mu myaka 3 n'amezi atatu. So we are going to give suggested answer for the last question. The last question is question 5, which states that define the following terms: ordinary share, loan, SACCOs, interest rate in the cooperative, and corporate taxi. So the answer A, ordinary share. An ordinary share represents equity ownership in a company, proportionally with or other ordinary shareholders according to their percentage of ownership in the company. Hano ordinary share represent equity in the company, equity ownership. We know that equity is residuary interest after deducting or external liabilities. Cyo dusigarana niki ni equity. Proportionally with all other ordinary shareholder according to their percentage of the ownership in the company. So ordinary share provide, ordinary share are share provide investors with a voting right. Ordinary share ni share ziha umushoramari uburenganzira bwo gutora. One share vote per share and represent the proportionate ownership of the company. Kandi iyi share is ordinary share ziba zihagarariye agace umuntu yoboneze cyangwa se afite muki muri company. Ordinary stock shareholder receive fluctuating dividend payment. Hano ordinary depending on the company's performance. Zino ordinary share abazifite bagenda babona dividend zitandukanye bitewe n'ukuntu company yongutse babanza kwishyura ordinary stock shareholders receive their dividend payment after preferred stock shareholder. Kuvuga ngo abantu bafite zino ordinary shareholder bakira dividend ariko hamaze kwishyurwa preferred stock holders. So the loan, what is loan? So a loan is amount borrowed by business from lenders. Loan tuzi kama amafaranga aguzwa na business avuye kuba yamugurije. Ushobora kuvuga ko nanone loan is the lending of money by one or more individuals, organization, or other entities to other individuals, organization, etc. The recipient borrower incurred debt and is usually able to pay interest on that debt until it is paid, as well as to repay the principal amount borrowed. Loan hano ushobora kuvuga ko ari uburyo bwo kuguriza amafaranga bukorwa n'umuntu cyangwa se ushobora kuba ari umuntu umwe cyangwa se ari abantu benshi cyangwa se ari organization ikayaguriza nyine ikindi kigo. Uwakiriye amafaranga akaba agiyemo umwenda, akaba afite kuba yaryozwa cyangwa se yabazwa kuba yakishyura inyungu kuri uwo mwenda agiyemo kugeza uwo mwenda wishyuwe. So SACCOs standard for saving and credit cooperative, which is a microfinance organization that provide financial services to the lower population or powers. SACCOs ni ikigo cy'imari iciriritse gitanga serivisi z'imari ku bakene no ku baturage bo mu cyaro. So interest rate are fees charging for utilization of loan. So interest rate turabona ko ari amafaranga cyangwa se ni fees baca umuntu nyine ko aragiye gukoresha iki ari amafaranga bamuhaye. Are proportion of amount rent given to the lenders. Na agace ka amafaranga batije baha uwayatije, which provide incentive for the lender to engage in the loan. barakampa kugira ngo bimotive kuba ubundi yatanga iki yatanga ayo mafaranga. For the recipient ari we twita kwa yakira twita borrower, interest rate are cost of raising money borrowed, ni igiciro cyo gukoresha iki ayo mafaranga bamuhaye. Ariko for the giver ari twita the interest rate are the return on investment made in another company, nari bagaruje kuyo bashoye mu yindi company ari twita finance income. So the corporate tax is levy placed on a firm's profitability by the government. Hano corporate tax turabona ko ni payment ni ubwishyu bukurwa ku nyungu yabonwe n'amakampani akubugakurwaho na guverinoma. The money collected from the corporate tax is used as a nation's sources of income. Aya mafaranga nayo ni isoko cyangwa se ni source ya income igihugu kibona. So the farmers operating earnings are calculated by deducting expenses including the cost of a good sold and depreciation from revenues. Next, tax rate are applied to generate legal obligation that the business owes to government. So dear friend, dear followers, dear brothers of this Patera TV, this is the end of our session today. Vrovs giving suggested the answer for the written exam for the loan officer exam. Dear friend, subscribe on this YouTube channel, share this video to your friend, to your groups. Like, if you have any question, any queries, comment below on these TVs, on these videos, and we motivate us. What we are going to do to this video is valuable asset to us. Thank you for watching. God bless you.